Welcome and good morning at Swing to Sleep and Smarla. I want to introduce you to Smarla today and also talk a bit about the history of Swing to Sleep so that you understand more about the big advantage of the Smarla motor and why Swing to Sleep is so useful and helpful in a child's life. Yeah, Swing to Sleep started 24 years ago. I was a dad to a crybaby myself. Today she's 24. Her name is Aileen. And the parents can simply express gratitude to my daughter for the fact that this product even exists. Without her, it would have never existed. We spent nights on pizza boxes. We hopped around. I had a pain in my back. My wife was completely overwhelmed. And that's how it all came about. Then a midwife saw that afterwards at our place. Right at the beginning, it was super basic. In the past, we used to rock our baby in a kind of sling or blanket and found that it would calm down and become more relaxed. And that's how everything ultimately developed afterwards. And back then, there was no internet like there is today. Modern had a bit of a, or something like that, and then something built up there. No real answers, as we wanted to know why our baby is crying so much and how we can help our baby. So during that period, when I was involved in product development, I had an informative chat with a knowledgeable neurologist. He came from America, from New York, so it was all about vibrations, and he really emphasized that we need to make sure we have the smoothest possible vibration amplitude. We'll discuss vibration amplitude in detail in a separate video later, where we'll explain everything we've focused on, you know. And in any case, it was like that we experienced relief. The baby slept, my wife had time to meet herself again, could meet our child in a completely different way, and as a result, a completely different situation arose, also in our marriage, in our partnership between my wife and me. And that's also what many reflect. In the past, we handled all communication with the parents ourselves, and that was always amazing. We knew that if we sent one out on Mondays, because we were already recognized in mixed groups back then on Wednesdays or Thursdays, the phone would ring and we already knew what it was. Then it was like, hey, do you hear something? And we were like, no. Yeah, we wanted to say thanks because my husband and I finally have time for each other again. And then in the past, we were like, the product doesn't just stand on its own, but we're more like trendsetters, you know? And how crucial is it in the present day for children to have the experience of growing up in a communal relationship? That's common knowledge now, but we already discussed that in a previous video. We will link that here again. I want to tell you a little something today. We had sleep experts on board offering their expertise here in the Smarla, our dedicated space for sleep and relaxation. We engaged in a conversation with the University of Tübingen, with whom we collaborated and worked on various things together. And with a grand total of 30,000 customer surveys, you know, customers who have actually utilized our product, we asked them, like, what are your desires? And the first wish was actually, and as you can hear, it is extremely, 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 extremely quiet. In fact, it is so quiet that you can hardly hear a sound, not even a whisper. So that was one of the very first wishes, you know, and there were many, many other wishes that we will address in the videos. So one thing that we desired was a different method to access the hammock. Alternatively, what they wanted was a different design for it. Back in the day, it was more like form follows function. And by now, it was important that the design blends in with the surroundings. Essentially, in a living room or bedroom, it primarily functions as a design element, adding aesthetic value to the space it occupies. And we have also implemented that here. We ensured that we are not up here, but there are also individuals who are a little smaller than me and still have the desire to operate the engine. You don't have to operate it, but we'll explain that in another video. Get ready to see what comes up. It automatically detects when you put your child in. However, in this location, we possess the engine. In this location, we possess the touch control for the speed. This wooden ceiling is not only a design element, but it also aids in reducing the noise levels. And when it comes to the frame, we made sure that the frame doesn't make any noises, but really, and also doesn't transmit any, but really quiet. And this whole thing continues throughout the entire intelligent design, even down to the suspension of the springs, suspension of the hammock, really placing a focus on noise development and also incorporating it into the design of the family and user friendliness. All other topics will be covered in the videos, and you will discover more in the upcoming series about our product. If you like this, go ahead and like this video, leave a comment if you have any unanswered questions, and subscribe to the channel. All the best. Yours truly, Maik.